inside, niños.
It's bad.
No, it's something else. You're mine! So, you fall back on cheap magic tricks, trying to disappear. Yet you don't know how to be truly invisible. Now, I give you permission to die. You're just like all the others, broken.
Unbreakable.
What's happening?
KO!
You! That can't taste good.
Both fighters were intense physical threats, but only one wielded the superior Venom.
Venom had many advantages over Bane. Speed, durability, versatility, and even strength.
Bane's peak strength was at most just enough to lift a 27-ton car. Meanwhile, Venom was strong enough to stop a falling carnival ride and hold it up by himself, even while in a weakened state. Comparing it to similar carnival rides, my very conservative estimate would place this thing weighing around 200 tons.
Way more impressive than anything Bane ever lifted.
Of course, Bane was smarter. However, even if he had deduced Venom's key weaknesses to fire and sound, he wasn't really equipped to take advantage of them.
As for speed, Venom could catch bullets. Even better, he could catch up to bullets in midair. He had to move over 1,500 miles per hour to do that.
Ironically enough, almost twice the speed of sound.
Surprisingly, their durability levels were pretty even. Both have taken hits from Superman-level beings and lived to fight another day.
The big difference being Venom's healing factor was far superior. He could fight on par with Juggernaut, who can make 4.8 magnitude earthquakes with his bare hands.
But it's not like Batman ever needed super strength to knock Bane out cold.
In time, Venom's superior strength, speed, durability, and versatility simply overwhelmed Bane.
Looks like Venom was the real Bane of this fight.
The winner is Venom.